Collier County schools announced they would lock all doors before the shooting even happened. NBC2's Alexis Santos is live from Osceola Elementary with new information about these security changes.
Osceola Elementary here is one of three schools that starting Monday will have its front doors locked to all visitors. Now, Collier County schools have added this extra layer of security in the wake of the Parkland shooting, as well as several threats made towards schools here in Collier County. School shootings remain top of mind for Collier County parents.
Today I saw the news and I was really sad about it.
Not only are national events bringing the concerns to the forefront, but Collier County schools have dealt with several threats in the last couple of months.
I'm really worried about my children, yes.
In the wake of all the tragedies and newfound fear, Collier County schools decided to take action.
We've been looking throughout the semester at every security option that's possible to add to our schools.
The latest, locking the front door at all of the schools, which is the only point of entry, a new layer of security the district hopes will be effective.
But we feel this is the next logical step.
Anyone coming to the school as a visitor has to buzz in, state their name, reason for being there, and show their ID. People can only get inside the school.
You're all good? Thank you.
Thank you.
If the front desk staff approves entry.
They are doing something and I'm happy about it.
Visitors will still need to be screened in the front office once they're let in. Some say there's still more that needs to be done, or the district took too long to get this up.
It would be better if they did like a couple years ago.
But for now, the district says this step is the start of making its school safer.
We're constantly looking at what else we can do.
The other two schools that will have the new lock system up and running come Monday will be Immokalee High School and Gulf Coast High School. Now, all 50 schools in the Collier County Public School District will have this system up by the start of the new school year. Reporting live in Collier County, Alexis Santos, NBC2.